How I like my metal. So, I don't know if many of you have seen this old Norwegian commercial. It's funny, but there's a point to this. So this is me. So yeah. So yeah, that's me. I'm like diehard metalhead, you know. Okay, so anyone that knows me or knows my channel or, you know, knows my musical endeavors knows that I am a metalhead and I have been a metalhead all my life. I mean, yeah, I love other stuff too, but essentially metal flows in my freaking veins. But I have this
deep dark secret,
this guilty pleasure that I don't talk about often, and that is my love for catchy pop stuff. Like, do I like Demi Lovato? I do. You know, I like artists like Banks and Halsey and, you know, stuff like that. I get into it. You know, if it's a little darker, if the subject material, if the subject matter is a little, you know, not so bubblegum, but, you know, has a little bit of significance to it, you know, I'm even more on board. If it's catchy, you know, it is what it is. I don't know why I'm like this.
Why am I like this?
But yeah, so this has been eating me alive for the past, like, couple of days. I noticed that both Halsey and Lana Del Rey both dropped a new video, and I've desperately been wanting to watch both of them, but I can't because I was waiting to react to them, and I wanted to wait until Monday because I had this really cool shirt that I wanted to wear with this hat. I was going to wear the two of them together to react to these videos, but I can't wait. Like, so I put on this shirt.
Fuck my life.
Yeah, so before we jump into, because I'm going to do both of those in this video, because I know most of the people who are metalheads aren't really going to want to watch that. And that's fine, I understand.
Sure.
James Charles.
Hi, sisters.
Jeffree Star.
Hi, how are ya?
Tati Westbrook.
Hey, guys.
The drama. So, you know, all of this shit is going down. Everybody's got a story. Everybody's got their side. People are exposing each other. It's like this person's telling the truth. Now this person's finally telling the truth. So it's like everybody is like one-upping the other. And, you know, who's telling the truth? Who's not telling the truth? This story, this whole fucking thing is just getting bigger and bigger. And it's taking weird turns left and right, and it's just going to keep getting weirder. Yeah, I promise you, it's not over yet, and, you know, we still don't know everything. How much do I care? Not that much. Like, I really, it's hard for me to care that much about this. Is it interesting? Sure, it is entertaining on some level, kind of. But honestly, I just wanted to use the names in the title to make it more clickbait. Sue me. I mean, no, don't sue me. For legal reasons, that was a joke. Brace yourselves. We are now going to react to Halsey. Nightmare. All right, so let's see what Miss Halsey has in store for us today.
My soul to keep. If I shall die before I wake,
I pray the Lord my soul to take.
Tasted blood and it is sweet. I've had the rug pulled beneath my feet.
Okay, so the very that last section that was like kind of grainy, like this right here, but it's like everybody out in the streets, and it was very reminiscent of like Joan Jett kind of vibe. For those of you old enough to remember Joan Jett, I like the way that was filmed, and the whole vibe and the graininess of it. That was really cool.
I've trusted lies and trusted men, broke down and put myself back together again. Sat in a mirror and punched it to shatters, collected the pieces and picked out a dagger. I've pinched my skin in between my two fingers and wished I could cut some parts off with some scissors. Come on, little lady, give us a smile. No, I ain't got nothing to smile about. I got no one to smile for. I waited a while for a moment to...
Okay, this video is incredibly suggestive on so many levels. So it was neat, the contrast when... that last grainy section where it was like everyone was kind of looking like 80s Vogue models, you know, with the suit and the slick back hair, and then it was flashing between that and her with the bloody mouth, and that was interesting. A lot of jump shots to different things, and then, you know, this and the leopard and the very suggestive movements. Yeah, this is an interesting video thus far. I really need to get into the lyrics, because it seems like this might be dealing with like self-esteem or mental health on some level. Because I know she said something about wanting to cut stuff, and they had like the diagrams on the chick's stomach, like the doctors who do cosmetic surgery. Okay.
Say I don't owe you a goddamn thing. I keep a record of the wreckage of my life. I gotta recognize the weapon in my mind. The dark shit, but I love it every time. And I realize no sweet dream, but I'm a hell of a night. That I'm no sweet dream, but I'm a hell of a night. No, I won't smile, but I'll show you my...
I'm no sweet dream, but I'm a hell of a night. That is a very interesting song lyric. It reminds me of that one Taylor Swift song. I forget what the lyric is or the name of the song, but I know... I didn't say that.
My teeth, and I'ma let you speak if you just let me breathe. I've been polite, but won't be caught dead. Letting a man tell me what I should do in my bed. Keep my exes in check in my basement, cause kindness is weakness, or worse, you're complacent. I could play nice, or I could be a bully. I'm tired and angry, but somebody should be. Come on, little lady, give us a smile. No, I ain't got nothing to smile about. I got no one to smile for. I waited a...
Oh, I get it now. I think. Oh, this is borderline political, or maybe it's just straight up political, but, yeah, I think this is a kind of, not necessarily in response, but maybe kind of in response to everything going on right now with, Georgia and Alabama and Ohio, you know, and the underlying things behind those issues. The fact that it's not just about what they're saying it's about, but, you know, the deep-seated, like, kind of vilifying women for... I'm gonna keep my mouth shut.
For a moment to say I don't owe you.
Wow, this video so far, I might have been way off base with that last part. It was just like lyrically and with the visuals of the video, it kind of seemed like it might be going in that direction, or that might have been the basis or the theme. Once I started thinking about the whole, like, having to look a certain way, like I was looking way too into it. I did a collab earlier today, kind of on that subject matter, so, you know, my brain's still kind of there. This video, I mean, it's good. The song, I like it. I'm not gonna lie. I'm feeling it. Visually, it's just, there's so much, so many different things, and I mean, they're kind of like cycling through, and the imagery and the drastic difference in the images in the sections is it keeps you kind of hooked in. It's good job.
Someone like me can be a real nightmare, completely aware, but I'm glad to be. So save me your prayers. I keep a record of the wreckage of my life. I gotta recognize a weapon in my mind. They talk shit, but I love it every time. And I realize I keep a record of the wreckage of my life. I gotta recognize a weapon in my mind. They talk shit, but I love it every time. And I realize I'm your sweet dream, but I'm a hell of a
night. What a fucking cameo. It's funny, earlier, because when I said Joan Jett, I was thinking Blondie at the same time, you know, and I was thinking that with the part. That's fucking crazy. It's Deborah Harry.
No sweet dream, but I'm a hell of a night.
Wow. Just wow. So yeah, there was a lot going on in that video. I know there was a ton of little things that I probably could have paused and elaborated on, because I noticed a bunch of little things going on in like the background and certain little like things that probably were key elements to the meaning of the song that I'm not gonna say I missed, because you know, I didn't miss them, I just didn't pause and like take them in the way I normally would. But yeah. So, I mean, all in all, that was a good video. It was a great song. I can't hate on it. But then again, I generally don't hate on Halsey anyway. I first became a fan of Halsey when I learned that, you know, she's another one of those artists that suffers from bipolar disorder. That's kind of what got me into Demi Lovato. You know, I didn't really care much for Demi Lovato before I found that out, but then I was like, you know, I wonder if some of her music reflects, like, if her lyrics reflect that. because as some of you may know, most of you probably don't know if you haven't like gone into my channel beyond the reaction videos, I have bipolar disorder type 1 with rapid cycling. And you know, it's cool to see people like celebrities or, you know, music, people who are in the music industry talk about it, or, you know, come forward about their struggles, and to have that in their lyrical content is just something to relate to and respect, because it is a struggle and it sucks. And you know, it's cool to not only just not feel alone, but to know, to see people who are achieving their dreams and doing something, they're putting themselves, you know, on another level and still managing this illness, you know, if that makes sense. So yeah, kudos to Halsey. Okay, so I thought I was going to be throwing a Lana Del Rey video in here. I thought I was going to be reacting to a new Lana Del Rey video. But no, that is not the case. The thumbnail was very misleading. A new song dropped, but it's not a video. It's just a song. And I don't like reacting to just a song. If I'm going to react, there's going to be a video. I need visuals. I need visuals. So that apparently is not happening in this video. So this is just about Halsey and me. And but so yeah, I'm officiating a wedding next Saturday, and I'm wearing this hat. And I got this like really sick shirt that I'm going to be wearing with it. Not this sick shirt, but another one. Oddly enough, it also has flowers. It's got like silver roses. It's like a black button up, you know, all button up dress shirt, but it's got like these real bright shiny like silver roses on it. And I got these like sick shoes to wear with it. I'm excited. This is gonna be the first wedding I officiate. I'm gonna be officiating funerals too one day. Put the fun back in funerals.